This is the second part of my oscilloscope tutorial showing you how to measure stuff with an oscilloscope. The first thing you're going to have to play with is your oscilloscope probe. You should have gotten one with your oscilloscope, but if you didn't, you can get one for 10 bucks from mpja.com. All oscilloscope probes will have a little attenuation switch where you can set them to X1 or X10 attenuation. 99% of the time, you just want to leave it set to X1. The X10 setting just divides the signal by 10, which you usually don't want to happen unless you're working with high voltages. The oscilloscope probe will have a BNC plug on the back that you plug into the scope, like this. Once that's done, you don't need to unplug it again. The probe will have two main parts, the ground clip and the tip. The ground clip is just a little alligator clip that you're supposed to attach to the circuit ground or circuit common. If you don't know what that means, just connect the ground clip to the negative terminal of your battery. Now the other important part is the probe's tip. When you want to measure the voltage in the circuit, you touch the tip of the probe to the part of the circuit you want to observe. You can also use these probe clippy things to grab wires in the circuit, leaving your hands free to do other stuff. Now I'm going to connect my probe to a signal generator so I can show you some nice easy examples. So now that you have your probe clipped onto a part of your circuit, you should see some sort of signal on the screen. Now let me explain what you're seeing. The screen is evenly divided up into little squares or divisions. Each division represents a certain number of volts on the vertical axis. On the horizontal axis, each division represents a certain number of milliseconds or microseconds. Right now I have things set up to be 1 volt per division and 1 second per division, for the sake of simplicity. Now as you can see, it's not so easy to see what's happening in this signal, so we want to sort of zoom in and out. Now we do this by changing the volts per division and the seconds per division. The exact setting you will use will depend on the signal you're viewing and your personal preferences. And there's no harm with messing with these settings, so you can zoom in and out all you want until you get a good feel for what's happening. Also, you can use these little positioning knobs to move the waveform up and down so it fits nicely on your screen. The next thing I want to talk about is DC coupling, AC coupling, and ground coupling. All oscilloscopes will allow you to choose between these modes. DC coupling is generally what you want to use for most circuits because it'll allow you to view most DC voltages. For the sake of example here, I'm going to hook up my probe to a 9-volt battery. You can see how the line jumped up to show the presence of a DC voltage. If we count the number of vertical divisions, we can see that the voltage being shown is roughly 9 volts. Also, since I have a digital oscilloscope, I can see that it's doing the measurement for me. However, sometimes you might want to ignore the DC component of a signal and only focus on the small AC variations. An example of this is if you're trying to discover if your circuit has a nicely filtered power supply. So let's look at my simulated example. Over here you can see a power supply that looks like it's 5 volts. But if I set my scope to AC coupling and zoom in, I can see that in fact there are some tiny AC voltage variations laid on top of the DC signal. Now according to the display, each division is representing 100 millivolts, so the AC ripple of this signal is approximately 100 millivolts from peak to peak. Now 100 millivolts is fine, that's only 2% of the DC voltage of 5 volts, but if you ever run into a DC power supply with several volts AC on it, you know that something is screwed up and you gotta fix it. Now remember the final type of coupling I talked about? Ground coupling? That basically just means that you aren't measuring anything at all. You're just measuring ground. In other words, it's kind of a useless setting, and the only time you ever use it is when you want to reposition your waveform to represent 0 volts right in the middle of the screen. Finally, I want to show you a real-world example on this headphone amplifier I built. You can see that when I crank up the volume, I'm getting massive fluctuations in the power supply voltages. So, what's the solution? I have to add some capacitors to smooth out that voltage. Now here's what it looks like after the capacitors are installed. Much better. And the sound will be better too. So that's 99% of what you will ever need to know about oscilloscopes. Now if you want to become an expert, check out the next episode where I'll talk about some of the more advanced functionality of oscilloscopes.